Just gonna kind of use this to brush away. Try to keep anything I can from falling in there.
Now, if it has brake fluid and we still don't have brakes, we may have an issue on our hands.
I don't know if it doesn't have brakes.
I know.
We haven't even tried to move it yet. That's what this episode's all about. All right, well, we know it'll run. Going hot. Okay. Ready?
Almost started there.
Have to get a carburetor rebuild kit. We might have to see if it drives. I have the lovely Inara accompanying me today. She loved the camera. She loved to boogie. Hopefully she's not too terribly loud for you guys. Where we left off, I went and bought a carburetor rebuild kit. Now, what you guys may not know is that when I got to the O'Reilly's to get the carburetor kit, I brought the carburetor with me, so I made sure I got the right carburetor kit. And when I set the carburetor on the counter, this little tube right here, it fell over and bumped and dirt came out. Like there was a pile of dirt here. And that dirt, this was right off the engine right after we had it running, was not wet with fuel. We have a fuel clog somewhere. No idea where that's at. It could be somewhere else down the line. But as for right now, we're gonna break down our carburetor. This is our carburetor kit. And I put this in Gogo's truck so it wouldn't get damaged, and it got a little damaged. So we're good to go. It's all right. As long as everything's there and it works, I'm happy. There's our float. I got one of those just in case. So let's look at our one barrel carburetor here. I gotta take this bad boy apart. You know what I probably should have is a container to hold all these screws. That would probably be pretty smart. Air cleaner gasket, clearly garbage. I know I'm gonna have to pull that, and I might take that outside. Just turn it. What? Seriously? It's all flathead, flathead, flathead Allen wrench. Guessed it on the first shot. All right, so in theory, wow, that came right apart. Let's take a little look at this linkage here. That popped right off. This gasket doesn't look like it's in that bad of shape. What? That got a divot in it. Ours doesn't have that. Is it supposed to have that? The other side has it too, almost like it's supposed to be there. Divot on this side and one on this side. And this one has neither. So I don't know that it'll fit in there without that. But this looks remarkably clean for a carburetor from 1950s. I think this carburetor's been rebuilt, guys. If not, it just never ran before. Well, there's still dirt in it, look. That clip just fell out. I don't even know where that clip came from. I think it went on here. Is that bent? Why does that seem bent? There's remarkably nothing to this carburetor though. There's still more dirt in it. That still seems like it's bent. Cause that's a pretty stout piece of metal. I don't know how it bent. Oh, look at that. I don't think someone put this carburetor together right. Cause it looks all new, but that seal's messed up. That seems bent. I'm gonna have to show you guys the amount of dirt inside this thing. This table was clean before I started this. Ask everyone, I cleaned it. I went through the desert on a horse with no name. Good Lord. All right, well, we got that piece of our accelerator pump out. Yeah, I think this clip goes there. I think that's how that's supposed to go. You think that's why they parked it? Is because they didn't put the carburetor together right? Because there is nothing to this carburetor. But everything that could be wrong is wrong. Because look, it's relatively clean and down the venturis. You can see some of the scrape marks in there where I scraped at it with the screwdriver. It indicates how much dirt's in there. All right, let me see if I can break this bad boy here. I don't even know if I need to. But I think all we've taken out so far is 6 screws. So there's a little cotter pin there. That should be easy enough to get off. Let me go to those. I press it together, the clip goes to the outside. Brilliant! See, that gasket looks good too. That looks reusable, that looks clean. Doesn't look like it's had too much fuel in it. See, it's not gonna work like that. That's gotta be bent. Does anybody know in the comments below, is that bent? I mean, the E-clip was not on it, it fell out by itself. Brilliant, I just broke that. Well, hopefully that's in the kit. I'm gonna have to take that jet off to get that off. I think I gotta take that bit off right there. Can you all see in there? It looks clear. I can see through it pretty easily. Still try to keep this intact as best as I can. That way I can line it up with another gasket. Oh, that's a tricky one to put in. I have to take off the needle and seat, don't I? I don't know. This is boggling me. I don't know if it was good or if it wasn't good. I don't know if I could just clean it up and throw it back together and call it good. You all already know I'm not a carburetor guy for the most part. Let's check our gaskets real quick. All right, that gasket definitely looks like that gasket. This thing seems so simple, yet so complicated at the same time. That's probably our intake manifold gasket. That probably goes right there. Yeah, pretty much lines up. It looks like it might work. But we did not get a new air cleaner gasket, which is arguably the worst gasket we have. Oh, wait, we may have. Nope, that's not it. Nope, wrong. So we'll save garbage over here. That still does not answer my question on whether this is bent or not. And it did not come with another one of these either. Or did it? Is that what this is? It is what that is. Does that fit? Okay, it does fit, but that begs a whole new question. Does that mean we gotta try to fix L broke in here? That all seems right. But the top is clearly wrong. I don't think that's bent. Do you think these tiny little new noses have it in it? Seems like it works a lot better. Alright. I didn't bend that though that I know of. Maybe I did. I'm gonna have to run this one by Grandpa. I'll probably call him. I'll probably take y'all with me real quick so we can try to break off our fuel line here. I'll get back with y'all. Okay, that was too easy. Dude, did we break this already? Well, there was a filter in there, and it was clogged. It's just dirt. The entire thing's just dirt. There's no reason to get any chemicals involved. If I just got a bucket with hot water, that's what I need. Why am I overcomplicating this? What in the brake fluid is going on here? Who needs paint stripper with brake fluid? Another day, another stab at this carburetor. Put the sniper barrel on there. I did pull our check valve out and lost half, two-thirds of it. I did get a new brush to try to get some of that dirt out. I wonder if I hit it first before I tried to hit it with the carb cleaner. Wish I could find another one of these that's a little bit more narrow. Might have to make one. Just trying to break up all the dirt inside this bowl. That way I can spray it out. Like I said, this carburetor wasn't very dirty, so it should be easy enough to just knock out real quick. Never mind that project over there. We're working on our carburetor right now. I don't need any questions asked. Yeah, I don't need any questions asked about this project. If you have any questions, you gotta watch our second channel, Sullivan Racing. Oh! I knew it was gonna happen! That's why I hesitated. I hesitated because I knew it was gonna happen. I still did it. Dang it. Did I leave that loose enough? No, I'm gonna need a flathead for that. It's best to do this with a ball bearing underneath. Where all this stuff is here, so if I drop it and lose it, it'll be lost forever. I guess the real big kicker is, can we get the accelerator pump to work? Because that's what I think is going to determine 90% of this. All right, carburetor assembly. So we went down to the hardware store yesterday. They gave me this little pack, which is a carburetor kit. This is our accelerator pump for the carburetor, the original. Oh, sorry, accelerator pump. Plunger. Here's our accelerator pump plunger that came in our kit. Notice it's got like a leather gasket on it. This one has a rubber gasket. This rubber's breaking off, so it's fragile. We need an accelerator pump. And their solution was to use this plunger by just taking off the spring and the cup that goes to it and putting it on here. I wish I had a pick. But that's what we're gonna try to do right now, is try to take this off as gentle as possible and then move it to here. That one I don't care about. We could tear that off. This is the closest thing I found to a pick. A small screwdriver in our computer case. Let's see if we can pull this out without breaking it. Alright, so far so good. Maybe we could use that little cut there to... Has anybody else done this? Usually, I've seen them come, the cups come in the kit by themselves, but I've never seen this whole... Coming with the plunger thing is new to me. Okay. I mean, it had to go on, so it's got to come off, right? All right. So far, so good. That doesn't look like it's torn or ruined or anything. Okay, I was trying to be gentle and take that one off, but it just brittle. I think that we should put the rubber cup on first. There we go. Now we'll put our spring on. There we go. Let's see how well it fits. Oh, if I can do this with the light involved. There we go. Pretty sure this is the one for here. So that was $30, just to let y'all know. I don't think we got a new one for that. Okay, so that one goes there. Then big boy here goes on top. I'm gonna have to find the E-clip before we go any further. But again, that clip might have been bad, that's why it broke. Well, that looks like it's just gonna fall back off again. Okay, so I think that's how that goes. But I don't think this clip's gonna work very well. I think it's gonna fall off. Yeah, see the gap there? That's just gonna fall right off. That's the E-clip that came on it. But see, that's loose too. I guess not completely loose. I think I could do one of these to it and make it work better. Look, it's misshaped. You see how misshaped that is? I might have to go find an E-clip or something, because that's not gonna fly. Well, I almost lost that forever. And now I think I can lose it forever. Great. Yeah, it just shot off and I lost it forever. Since I lost that E-clip, we're pretty screwed right now. But what can I do to fix this? I actually have an idea. All right, so what if we use our little clip here? And I do this number here, right? Do you think that'll work? Should I do both sides? So if I did this. Now that does not come off whatsoever.
Guess who's here?
Guess who got the accelerator pumped together and then rigged it.
And then rigged it.
Well, actually the whole thing was a rig because we took the accelerator pump out of another kit, cannibalized it, then put it in here, but the E-clip I lost forever.
So 55 is gonna get rainy today?
I don't know. I'm trying to build the carburetor right now. That's the plan. Okay, so it did come with a new one of these. Let's make sure they're pretty similar here. And they are. Okay. Have they invented a carburetor anti-seize yet? Because they should. So let's put our gasket on. Is this right or is this wrong? This is wrong. Why don't y'all tell me it's the wrong gasket? Thought it was weird that it didn't cover that screw hole right there. Let me try this one. And it doesn't fit over this here. Maybe it is right. Then we gotta put our float on. What else was there? Man, it just seems like there's not enough here. Does anybody else feel like there should be more to this carburetor? Okay, that was the old gasket. So yeah, we have the right one on here. Together. I'm gonna put this together. Rochester, marked for GM. Here's this screw. Put all my extra pieces in the box. Yeah, that lines up pretty good right there. I'm not missing that bolt. I just didn't realize. Why do I have a feeling that's supposed to go on the other side? No? Maybe it is supposed to go here to connect that. All right. Just push it out here. Okay. Now we just need to put a clip on that. That's backwards. Can I just loosen it up and spin it instead of taking things apart? Perfect. Well, there's the screw. There's the spring. Well, without that, I guess I could figure out how this is supposed to go on. Well, it looks like it's supposed to go this way. Not a carburetor guy, isn't it obvious? Welcome to Obviously Not a Carburetor Guy. I'm your host, Fake It Till You Make It. Oh, okay. Ta-da. That makes sense. So yeah, this is supposed to go like this. This is a choke cam, right? So see how it tapers as it... Okay, so our other camera might have died. But you can see now, this is just our choke. So this operates the throttle body and the accelerator pump. This is the choke. The choke's on a cord, or it should be.
This is literally impossible to do with this closed end wrench.
Easier if my dad took this hood off. And I think he knows that. Now I'm able to get the wrench on there. Take it for you guys to tell me that I was going the wrong way in the comments.
We gotta follow that. See where that choke comes through the firewall there?
Uh-huh.
Then where does it go?
Right here.
I don't think that's the same one. That's electric. It's electric.
Is this a choke? No.
Oh, the choke's broke off. Apparently, that's the choke. I don't think the choke's gonna work. Now look in there to see if any... Can you all see in there? I can't. I need a light. You know what? Get a screwdriver. I want to check something real quick. I don't think it's getting fuel. We're gonna disconnect this and see if we're getting any fuel first. I don't see any leaking. That's a good sign, right? I told you guys the carburetor line was full of dirt. Wonder if the fuel line is too. We might need a fuel line real quick. Maybe I'll just change it anyway. Yeah, that's dry as a bone. Take that one off. Now connect those two wires just real quick.
This one.
Don't touch the frame. That's why I had it dangling there. It's just sticking out right there. It's right there. You're overcomplicating this. There's our answer. Our fuel pump's crap. Grandpa's fuel pump has failed us again.
What if it's the fuel filter, not the pump?
Do the fuel filter test. No restriction whatsoever. Mr. Gasket, your fuel pump has failed us. Granted, it is one we found in Grandpa's shop that could or could not be 40 or 50 years old.
Accurate.
So I guess we need to go get a fuel pump.
Catch you next time on Project Sullivan.
Catch you in a couple minutes on Project Sullivan. What is he talking about? We're gonna need an electric fuel pump for your race car anyway, right?
Yeah.
Can you go grab me a couple zip ties?
Never.
Probably in one of the electric boxes back there. Okay, let me see it.
I love the neon green with the red and the blue and the green.
Only show quality around here, Project Sullivan. Ah!
Yeah, that one works.
It's leaking everywhere.
I'm on it. Can you hand me the flathead?
So it turns out when you got a working fuel pump, that's what it's supposed to look like.
Can we crank on it now? Except for all the millions of leaks over there. That's about 20 bucks right there. See that? That's about 20 bucks right there.
I don't know if 1 gallon is going to be good enough.
Oh, I heard it. Hit it.
Hit the throttle a little.
Which one's the throttle? Is this one the throttle?
The very bottom one.
Okay.
I could probably hit it from this side. There we go, it will run. Now can we get it driving for the Sprite? Let's kill it.
I think it runs better than my Nova Straight 6.
I think the idle's a little high.
I think so.
Hey Dad, your ghetto carburetor rebuild worked.
Right, we probably need to take that battery with us to throw it on the charger when we get home too. Actually, it looks like our carburetor is leaking a little too. That's probably just a Titan though. It does run, it runs. Will it run, yes. So today's Wednesday, right? And the parade is Saturday.
And I've already got my car ready.
Gogo's project's done. Mine is only partially done. We just found out it runs. We still want to probably change some fluids and see if this thing even moves under its own power. And to see if we'll even get to the parade with this truck. I guess you'll have to find out. We lucked out. Look at, it's almost dark on us too. I think it's Gogo's first time getting in it.
Oh yeah, well, now let's go to Albuquerque with the race car behind it.
It's actually pretty comfy, isn't it?
Yeah, it's kind of, it's not bad.
Just gonna kind of use this to brush away. Try to keep anything I can from falling in there.
Now if it has brake fluid and we still don't have brakes, we may have an issue on our hands.
I don't know if it doesn't have brakes.
I know.
We haven't even tried to move it yet. That's what this episode's all about.
Huh?
I'm surprised this thing has as many miles as it does because it's such a job-specific vehicle.
How many miles you got?
According to the dash, 61,000.
For this old, yeah. You know, I have an idea if we can't get the brakes working for the first. We should just put a stick outside the window.
That little black thing in the center is an indicator. You pour a little in, it pops up when it starts filling up.
Really?
Yeah. Logan, look under the truck.
Four.
See if there's any fluid coming out anywhere. I'm gonna keep pumping it.
It takes a lot of fluid to fill that system.
It may just be leaking out on the ground. I don't know.
Is it going down?
Well, it doesn't have a big reservoir. It feels like I'm getting pedal. Okay, is there a place I can feed this through?
You know, for how many miles this thing got, it still ain't got no cup holders.
Can you see this sticking out? Out from under the dash?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
How long do you need it?
It's gotta reach that primer button.
Oh, it'll work.
It almost goes outside of the truck.
Okay. Well, I'll leave this here. We'll go inside and connect it.
Okay. Just making sure.
This thing might win in the speed, but this thing has more power probably.
Oh, for sure. I think you're exactly right on that.
I think this thing's top speed is about 25 miles an hour.
If you're lucky. No, I'm just joking.
Do we have clutch? Oh, we do have clutch. I tested that yesterday.
I think it's mechanical.
Yeah. I'm just surprised it's not seized up.
Oh, look at that. That's some high class electrical tape right there. When it doesn't work for electrical tape, you can always use it to mask off your painting. I've disconnected our hot wire because I'm about to make another hot wire. I probably need Grandpa here so he can help me figure out how to hook up the generator to see if we can get it to regenerate the battery. Now, would I like to solder all these connections and do it all proper? Yes. Am I going to? No. Why? Because we got to get ready for the parade this weekend.
And it's Thursday.
And
the parade Saturday.
Okay, so now we just gotta figure our toggle switch. Now to move to the other side.
All I've gotta say is this thing...
Might have to do a little more work to get a car show out of it.
An all original 55 Chevy? You realize how rare that is?
If everything's wired right, you should be able to hit the on switch and the fuel pump comes on.
Toggle switch is toggling. Can you connect the battery?
Oh yeah. Hit the toggle switch! We have an ignition system. Zip tied, but we'll worry about that later on cleanup. What's the next step?
Tires.
We got tires we gotta do. We gotta fill it with water.
See if it'll move.
Probably tires is the next step. Wave your arms, Gogo.
Wacky inflatable flailing arm man. There you go. I can't say it.
Down here at the Wacky Inflatable Flailing Arm Man Emporium, you can find the best selection of Wacky Inflatable Flailing Arm Men.
Damn, you did that way too good. Makes me question what you do in your free time. But then I remember you never have free time, so.
Right.
Hey, that's our two-stroke gas.
Hey, that's our other fuel cell. If you have a 10-lug split rim Chevrolet, this 19.5 tubeless will fit. I already matched up the lugs. Took me forever to find this bad boy. We found him at the auction. You'll see the video up above. And this is what we're gonna run. Hopefully we can find some for the back that fit over the drum brakes. I love old trucks.
You gotta go on Buster out soon. Did it move?
I don't know. Did it?
I think it did.
Let me go find some baling wire, try to tie this fuel cell up, and we'll see if we can get this thing to run. Okay, I just got to rig up some fuel real quick to make our maiden voyage. It's already getting dark on me again. Found some baling wire here on the ground. Just twist that there. This one's a bit harder to twist, and apparently it's brittle. Well, hopefully that works. I really don't like that. Make sure that's all the way down. Don't run out of fuel. Let's do this. Well, let's see if it'll even go into gear, and then we'll find out if it stops.
Looks like an animal's been staying over there behind that thing.
Yeah, a deer.
That's what I thought.
That's where the deer lives. Bring our perfect interior down. No brakes.
not nasty. You got a knife?
Yeah. But I can't open that thing either. Apparently we're not gonna get it driving tonight after all.
I don't have the right size wrench.
Not 13/16. You're tying it too tight.
I didn't know how much oomph I had.
So we're headed back to the truck right now. Sorry for the noise of the road. I'm really worried that we're not gonna be able to do this because of the brakes. We're this close to making it. And now it's really gonna come down to brakes. Let's go. Hello?
How are we going?
I'm just gonna run to the house, put batteries on the charger.
I just got home.
Okay, so I'll meet you at the house then. Actually, I don't know if our truck's gonna make it to the parade. It has no brakes. Mark's Jeep is just not running good.
What's wrong with it?
It doesn't want to run right. The carburetor's bad on it.
Has he rebuilt it?
They couldn't get a kit, so they're kind of just piecing it together.
Alright.
Hardcore day 4, skipping carburetor day.
That's a 10 lug rim.
Yeah.
They're all, Uncle Scott's joining us today.
For a little while.
We got Go-Go again. Always. For a little while. It is said that this truck does not actually drive. It's got so much torque, it just moves the planet the direction you want it to and then stops. Obviously not for the parade, but Go-Go might be my brake to where we could at least get the concrete. That's the brake. We just got here. Let's see how our cold start goes on this hot day.
So what do you mean Go-Go might be your brake?
A little high. Go-Go, this is the emergency brake. As long as it drives, it runs better than Mark's Jeep. But Mark's Jeep probably stops a little better. Look at this. Overnight, the spiders moved in again.
That's how your knees are, that's for sure.
Well, I didn't put no air. I just threw them on. Those are the ones from the auction. It's got a lot more air than the one we took off. I don't know if it's supposed to be a 13/16, but it's going to be a 13/16. Holy cow.
It was cool.
It took all the ugga duggas I had, but I did it. Yeah. Check this funnel out, Go-Go. This used funnel's cool.
I saw it yesterday. Well, it's going somewhere.
Damn it, I'm out of brake fluid.
Are you getting some kind of brake pedal?
A little bit. I'm out of brake fluid.
And I was gonna bring mine from my house.
I just bought this one yesterday and I'm out. Why would the brake line be that empty then? Oh, you know what? It's hard to see. That brake fluid just blends right in with the dirt.
It is coming out.
But it's dripping where I spilt a little.
Well, try and back it up a little bit and maybe we'll be able to see something.
It shows.
Find out if it moves.
It shows it's got some now.
It's still in the reservoir there. It's showing in the reservoir.
Yeah, it's showing now.
Ow. Low bridge. Ow.
So we got attempt number one here on the old 55.
Ow!
We need to do something with those tow mirrors.
Gilbert and Logan have stepped in for the first voyage. Still not sure if the brakes work.
Deactivate this?
Well, it definitely moves. Oh, the gas pedal is weak. I'm an idiot.
You don't say.
Well, the brake pedal's stuck in the floor.
It's not just that. I sat down, turned it on, put it in gear just to realize.
You have a block behind the wheel.
I never connected the throttle.
No brecas?
Yeah, well, I had the carpet over the gas pedal, and I'm like, oh, I got the carpet over the gas pedal. I can't. Oh, wait a minute. I don't even have the throttle connected. There, from there to there.
It's a wire?
There's a wire to that spot, and then there's a little piece of linkage that connects it from there to the carburetor. It's a little metal rod. Do you remember where we put that metal rod for that, Grandpa?
You had to load your car on that trailer, your grandpa's trailer.
Yeah.
How's your black truck running?
Pretty damn good.
You might have to use that.
Well, I believe it.
I'm planning on having to use my truck too.
Oh, I don't think this is going to tow. It's got a 2 5/16 ball anyway that I don't know if I get off.
You bought a new fuel pump?
Yes.
How much was that?
Too much. But I got the little bit higher pressure one because Gogo needs one for his race car anyway, I figured. Okay, we need to find a metal linkage for that throttle.
Yeah. Oh, what's the powder steering?
I'm surprised it's not powdered steering. That was scary. Why does that hood sound like it's falling? Oh, it's the door. Okay, now start it. Just real quick, I want to check something. The battery's charging.
I've got to have 14.2.
Yeah, but how dead is that battery right now? No, it doesn't have to be 14.2. As long as it's over 12, it's charging. It just may not be charging very fast.
No, you just check
it. No, wait, maybe it's not charging because it's 1300. Why is that battery at 13 volts? That battery I got from you is at 13 volts, Grandpa.
It says 13 now.
With it off. Well, it's nice to know our battery's definitely not charging. Push the pedal.
Push that and it went to the floor now.
It's on the floor now?
Yeah.
Yeah, that master cylinder's bad.
No, I got brakes now.
Yeah, but I could see it dripping out as you're doing it. Press the brake.
Go to the floor.
Yeah, you can see the master cylinder from this side. You press it and it starts dripping out like this.
Yeah, we'll rebuild that.
By tomorrow?
You gotta take it off. It don't take very long. There's only one cup. They're real simple.
We'd have to take that master cylinder off. What time is it?
11:54. I don't know where to start taking that thing off.
Well, it has two bolts and a hose connection. Now they might be all rusted.
I don't think we're gonna be able to make it.
Stop thinking that way.
Well, the master cylinder is just gonna hold us back, dude.
Okay, may. Well, if you don't make it now, you're never gonna get motivation to work on this thing again.
Okay, it's gotta be a 90 degrees from there. I need vice grips, Gogo.
Why are you liking old cars? Why are you liking working on old cars?
Better than the new ones.
Except you don't hit your head on the hood every time you try and get under it.
You know, I'll bet you one of them old mouth cylinders, like the newer style, bolt right up to this.
Now that I got it started, they might.
We're not gonna really know until we take that one off.
Yeah. Do you want to jump under there and take that one off, Gogo?
I don't even know how.
I don't either.
There's nothing to it. There's two bolts and a hose.
I'll give you a GoPro when you go. I think we're ready to install our 8-penny throttle. Oh, no, it was a 16-penny nail. I'm sorry. Hit the throttle.
It didn't come back.
Yeah.
It didn't come back.
Okay, now try it. Okay, flip the toggle switch, press the primer button. That's our 16-penny throttle right there.
Okay, that you can crawl under it now.
You down for the challenge, Gogo? Here we go, Gogo. You going down or am I?
We're gonna rock, paper, scissors for that.
Okay, we gotta get in the camera so you can't cheat.
Okay, cheat.
Ready?
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Okay.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Damn it. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
So all those, I won all of them.
No? Paper covers rock. I won the second one and we tied the third one.
Okay.
One more. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Damn it. This is Spider Country.
Here's the GoPro. You need a stick?
Well, I bought some.
Oh, that's GoPro. Leaking pretty bad.
Yeah, penetrating oil.
That's a hose clamp holding on our exhaust together. I don't see any bolts.
By the way, there's also a hose clamp being used as an exhaust clamp.
I don't see any bolts, do you guys? I don't see any bolts, like for real. I may have to have somebody come down here and tell me where these bolts are.
What two bolts?
There should be probably two bolts. I don't know what it is.
I don't see them.
Go get me a light out of the car. Well, that might make a little noise. Let's see if I can take that up real quick. Ooh, I'm gonna have to cut that one. Oh, it's on the exhaust pipe anyway.
I brought you the first light I found.
Hand me a stick, Gogo. Gogo, hand me the needle nose pliers.
Okay.
Okay, Gogo, here, put this somewhere where we don't lose it. How did I win at rock, paper, scissors and still doing the work? Man, I really need another week at this. This is where those ratcheting wrenches would come in handy, Gogo. You want to make sure when you're taking out brake lines, you use your best Project Sullivan line wrench.
Were you able to get it off?
As soon as I run out of threads.
Yes, I was wondering if you guys had a brake master cylinder for a 1955 Chevy.
6100.
6100. Yeah.
Ow, 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 ow. What are you doing?
Taking it apart.
Well, I know that. It was leaking like a sieve out that boot.
Did not know anymore.
I wonder if AutoZone has one like it, just not under the 55 models.
Well, that's why I said 3100.
It's not clean. Pretty good size. Pretty good shape on the inside.
You got one line, feeds all the brakes.
I told you. Okay. Anyway, we can go down to the parts store and see if we can get something like this at CarQuest.
Luckily, CarQuest had one for us, or we think. We're going to try it out.
Look at the other end.
It's still aluminum, though.
No, not that. Not width-wise. Look through it. Look at the hole.
They both have holes, Go-Go. It's just one's not clogged up.
There's one clogged. No, not those holes. Other way.
As long as this is the part that goes down, we should be fine. Was it like this, Dad?
Hmm?
Was it like that?
Now this goes like this.
Yeah.
And... it goes, no.
Man, I should have been here when you took it apart. See, that goes in the cap.
I don't remember now.
Anyway. It was 20 minutes ago.
That makes it flush. Yeah, that goes in first, and then this got to go before.
That's not what I was talking about. This goes in first, then that.
Well, I can't put the snap ring in until after we get this off. We gotta change this boot first. I even take it apart and I can see that you don't put the snap ring in yet. That's the wrong cup. We may have to change this cup over to there.
You know what it takes to do that?
Gas, we need to put this gasket on here. That, when you push the pedal, it's gonna get wedged in the aluminum and keep getting wedged further and further.
Well, that don't matter. This, the thing does. You can put something in there to stop it, a bolt or something. All we need is just a short bolt, so. For something to stop it.
Okay, so let's see if Grandpa's solution is gonna work here. That's too shallow still. That's pretty good.
5 seconds.
Come on, y'all. Follow me on this train wreck. Wow, that battery's gonna fly because it's hot. Now we're just gonna put our boot on. You can see we got our clip in there. Now we put our boot back on. This boot does not want to go on. Remember, I'm not a mechanic. I just play one on YouTube. By the way, that's the nut. That's pretty cool, I think. Although it would be cooler if they would have welded it in. Try my new ratcheting wrenches. I'm not gonna lie, I bought them just because I didn't want to deal with the, it took me forever last time. Now I gotta figure out how they work. Ow. It's always best to drop your light on your head. You know, if I was a real mechanic, instead of just playing one on YouTube, this would be kind of pathetic. Man, this thing takes a lot of swing. Yeah, it looks like it might be going back the old fashioned way. This one just takes too much swing and I ain't got a whole lot of swing in here. All right, you all died on me with the heat and all, you checked out. But if you can see, I got both our bolts in, our brake lines in, we just gotta put our rod in for our brake pedal.
I didn't think of it. But...
you're supposed to reuse cotter pins, right? And I just bent it a little because it was bent a little when I took it out and it's been here forever that I know of. Hey, Go-Go, come bleed these brakes. You just put a little in, pump, put a little in. look?
I mean, kind of.
You got any pedal?
Kind of. But it sounds like something's leaking down there.
Look under there.
Pop it!
Oh, shit.
What is it?
All the way up front. I like the front tires.
We got brakes until you get to the front where it all sprays out. Let me show you guys. So I gotta be at my real job instead of my YouTube mechanic job. All down there is caked with brake fluid. Our brake line gets to here and it basically gets destroyed. So we need to redo the brake system even more. We have to go in the parade anyway. We got Gogo's race car to put in. But I do not think our 55 is gonna make it. Forgive the noise in the background. We're just gonna have to face facts. That sucks because we put a lot of work into this. This is the second episode buildup, and we're just gonna have to suck it up and not have it in the parade. I'm out of time. I still gotta edit my entire video for this week. We still gotta get Gogo's car on a trailer. I still got my other job to do. I'm just out of time. Out of time. Out of money. As Gogo just said a minute ago off of Talladega Nights, there are good days in racing and there are bad days in racing. And this is a bad day.
If you've been watching this long, you might as well subscribe.
And remember, don't wait for opportunity. Create it.
Hey guys, it's me. Probably didn't know this, but we're going to a fiesta. We're going to a party at 7 o'clock.
Yeah, buddy, nice little roadrunner there. I like that Camaro. That's my favorite body style of Camaro. Look at that Mustang. You don't see Mustangs like that too often. In a convertible. Oh, look at that Camaro. That thing looks good. I like that. El Camino. That could have been us. So, a little upset we didn't make it to the parade, but while we didn't make it to the parade with our truck, we're still at the parade. You can watch the rest of that on our second channel, Sullivan Racing, where we try to get a race car ready for the parade in the same week.
And if you've been watching this long, you might as well subscribe.
And remember, don't wait for opportunity, create it.